ओम नमः शिवाय चिल्ड्रन। टुडे वी रीड अबाउट योर अनदर चैप्टर, चैप्टर 7, दैट इज द लैंड ऑफ डेंस फॉरेस्ट। नाउ व्हेन आई से अबाउट डेंस, इट मींस इट्स अ फॉरेस्ट वेर यू विल फाइंड अ लॉट्स एंड लॉट्स ऑफ ट्रीज। नाउ चिल्ड्रन, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट फॉरेस्ट, इट इज समथिंग दैट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज नेचुरल वेजिटेशन। व्हाई नेचुरल वेजिटेशन? Because it grows of its own by the help of the nature. Human being does not help such plants in growing. They grow of their own. So such forests are also called as natural vegetation. And when we talk about forest, it is all about greenery and dense. So today your chapter is all about the land of dense forest. Now see children, in our last video, I taught you chapter number 2, that was the latitudes and longitude. And when I told you about latitudes, I showed you the important latitudes and certain climatic zones that we have. Now here also you can see in your this video, I have shown you a diagram in the side. This is the our earth. The red line here is the equator. Then we have Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Now we read about few zones. If you remember, this zone was known name as Torrid Zone. Then the upper from here to here, from Tropic of Cancer till Arctic Circle, we have Temperate Zone. Then we have Frigid Zone towards the pole. Now see children, this is the sun. The sun rays directly fall on the equator, the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. In between, the sun rays fall directly. So this zone is called as the torrid zone, and torrid zone is the most heat or this region is receives more amount of heat compared to the various other zones. Now you can see the rays of the sun are low in other areas compared to the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. So children, this area is the torrid zone, and since equator is present, or the equator is the pole, important latitude here, this region is also called as the equatorial region. So today your chapter is all about dense forest. So we'll be reading the kind of forest present in this torrid zone, or you can say this is the zone. So this is the torrid zone, or you can say the equatorial zone. So we'll be reading about this zone, or the zone that have the dense forest over here. Changes in climatic condition from place to place. Now see children, as I told you, the latitudes help us to also know the various heat zones. Now see, here we have this part. Now see, these parts, or the equatorial zone or the torrid zone, we have the what heat kind of climate. Now moving ahead to the these from Tropic of Cancer, these area, these black ones in the north, towards the north and towards the south, are the temperate zone. And when you move ahead with the you can say towards the pole, this portion, we have the frigid zone, or you can say the coldest part of the earth. Okay, so we have various zone. So children, climate from place to place also varies. Now since the climate varies from place to place, it also depends on the kind of people, wildlife, plant that grow. Now you think you know about Kashmir, you live in Odisha, or you know about Kerala. The Kerala people or the Kashmir people, the way they eat, the way they wear clothes is different from us. You go to Kashmir, they wear very thick clothes to protect from severe cold. We wear cotton dress. Our winters are very less. One jacket or one cardigan is enough for us. So children, climate from place to place vary. And because of this climate, you will see the kind of forest or trees also vary. As per the climate, trees are also different. Next coming, variation in vegetation, wildlife, human habitation, etc. Just now I said, like human beings vary from place to place, even the animals, the kind of trees, even crops. In Odisha, whatever crop we grow, whatever fruits we eat, does not mean in every part of India it is available. So children, because of this climatic condition, places or things varies from place to place. Equator divides Earth into two equal halves. Already we read in our previous chapter. Now from the equator, if you move towards the north or the north pole, you will find variation in climate. Same way from equator to the south, if you go on moving, you will find variation in the climate. So the equatorial region or the torrid zone that we talked in our previous class extends from 0 degree till 10 degree north and towards the 10 degree south. So only this, now see, Tropic of Cancer is 23.5 degree north. The white dot line you can see here, we have the 23.5 degree north. And here Tropic of Capricorn is 23.5 degrees south. So less than that, from 0 degree till 10 degree, you think. Suppose 10 degrees around somewhere here. This is 10 degree, you think, consider. So from 0 degree till 10 degree north and towards the 10 degree south is the equatorial region. And in this region, whatever kind of forest and wildlife we have, we'll be reading in this chapter. Moving ahead, climate. Now when I talk about the climate, I told you before, it is the torrid zone of the earth, or it comes under the torrid zone. Now torrid zone is from 0 degree to 23.5 degree, but we are talking about the equatorial region particularly. So it is from 0 degree to 10 degree north and south. So in between, or we can say it is between the torrid zone. The equatorial zone is between the torrid zone. It receives direct rays of the sun. Already I told you children, and we talked also, since the rays fall directly on that part, so it receives heavy amount of heat and humidity. High amount of sunlight. Yes, because the rays are direct. Now see, as I told you again, let me show you. This is your earth. Now since the sun rays fall directly on that portion, now you can see this is the equator. Let me draw you equator. This is Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. So since the sun rays fall directly on the equatorial zone or the torrid zone, so the amount of sunlight is more. Okay, very hot and humid weather, receives heavy rainfall. Now see children, now we are having very hot climate. You see, if the whole day, for 2 days, if it is too much of hot in the evening or in the next day, you will see we have rainfall. Why? This happens because of evaporation. Now too much of heat carries away water through evaporation, and we have rainfall. So since this area also gets more amount of sunlight and heat, so again, this continues with the process of evaporation and the rainfall occurs. So such kind of area or equatorial region that we are reading about, here we have hot and humid climate with rainfall, heavy rainfall also. Moving ahead children with your next. The vegetation and wildlife. Now since we are talking about the land of dense forest, we should know what kind of vegetation or natural vegetation is found and the wildlife staying over there, or which kind of animals you will find in such a forest. Now see children, as I told you, we human beings also vary from place to place. You see, you go to Kerala, Karnataka, people are dark in complexion. You go to Kashmir, they are fully white. You will very rarely find a black. So why it happens? Because of nature, because of climatic condition. In the same way, children, the vegetation and wildlife also varies. Whatever you find in a particular equatorial region or some other region, not necessary. The same kind of trees and wildlife you will find in a different. Now take off a penguin. Talk about a penguin. Now see, penguin, polar bears, these are found in extreme cold climate where there is snow and ice glaciers. But such kind of animal will never resist in a hot and humid or hot area. So children, animals also vary from place to place. Now talking about the vegetation and wildlife over here, equatorial forests are known as evergreen forests. See children, as I told you, it is hot. And since heavy amount of sunlight or hot is received by this area, precipitation or rainfall are occurring very frequently. So since rainfall is occurring, this kind of forest are always full of trees. They never shed their leaves. Since rainfall is abundantly or heavily happens over there, so it is a evergreen forest. Evergreen means greenery every time. Trees in this forest are taller and are dense. Now when we talk about taller, this kind of forest have very tall trees, and the tall trees, when they grow up, their branches are so wide that they cover it and it looks very dense. Adequate amount of sunlight and rainfall help trees in this region to grow. As I told, forest or natural vegetation is such a thing which grows of its own by the process of nature. So with the help of sunlight and help of rainfall, the trees or the forest, in the forest the trees are found are grown automatically, or they grow by their own with the help of sunlight and rainfall. Examples, let me give you. Bamboo, lianas, ferns, these are a kind of example of such evergreen forest. Now see children, you take off example of Assam or Arunachal Pradesh, the northeast part of India. This area receives heavy rainfall, and even sunlight, you have sunlight throughout the 365 days. So in such area you will find these kind of trees. Variety of wild animals like monkeys, chimpanzees, snakes, squirrels. Yes, since it is a very very dense forest, you will find monkeys, chimpanzees, snakes, squirrels. These are kind of animals that are found in evergreen forest or in such a dense forest. If I give you example of a small movie, Mowgli. Everybody has seen that movie Mowgli. You see, he used to live in a jungle where there is dense forest. So such kind of forest is a dense forest, or you can say evergreen forest. Next is kind of human life. Now see children, since it is very dense, now when we talk about a forest, do you think it is possible for us to go and stay over there or leave there because it is very dense? Secondly, you have huge varieties of animals. Now animals are also dangerous for us. So since it is very dense, it is difficult for humans to stay over there. But you will find very few types of tribes. Tribes means Adivasi. So some nomadic tribes you will find, like examples I have given, Puba, Simangs. These are a kind of tribes. You see in your book, you have Kubas, Simangs and other tribes. Those you will find in such kind of forest. They live there. They do shifting agriculture. And now when I say about shifting agriculture, what is a shifting agriculture? And what does nomadic tribe means? Now nomadic tribes means they are Adivasis. Okay. So this Adi, if I say in Odia, they are Adivasi. What they do? They live in a place for 1 year or 2 years. There they grow they do agriculture, they eat, they grow crops, they eat it, and they, after they grow the crops, they leave that place and they move to another place in that jungle. So this is what shifting agriculture is. Ek jagah mein unhone apne liye crop banaya, wahan crop jab ho gaya, they move to a different place. So this is what is shifting agriculture. Now these tribe, they used to do shifting agriculture, and they move from one place to another frequently, very frequently. So they are called as also nomadic tribes. malaria is very much prevalent in such region. Now, children, when we talk about malaria, you know, we are advised we should not store water for so many days. We should not keep garbage for so many days. Now, when these things are dumped at one place and when there is rainfall, water logging happens and mosquitoes take birth. So these mosquitoes causes malaria. Now, when I talk about the dense forest or talking about this equatorial region, as I told, we have heavy rainfall over here. So due to heavy rainfall and water logging, malaria is very much prevalent in such region. So children, this was all about your chapter, The Land of Dense Forest. Now, in my next video or next class, I'll be sending you your exercises. Children, please go through the book, read it for 5 times, and whatever doubt you have, you can ask me. Thank you. Till then, thank you, children.